And we're back live, ladies and gentlemen, on the Philippe Matthews Show Network. Thank you for tuning in wherever you are around the world. I have Dr. Meg Blackburn Losey, my God, with me today. This is huge. She is, of course, you know, the author of The Children of Now and The Children of Now Evolution. If there's anyone who is a trendsetter, an advanced thinker, it's this woman. She is an advocate of Children of Now and describes them as a very special new generation who innately remains connected to the infinite. We're going to learn more about that in a minute. But first, I'd like to personally welcome Dr. Meg. Thank you for being with me.
Thanks for having me on. And hi, everyone. I so much appreciate you being there with us today.
This is fantastic. So when I had a conversation with you, I said, I would like for you to make a connection between the Children of Now and gun violence. But before we do that, can you just define what the Children of Now are and what they represent?
Sure. We people intuitive abilities, we've had knowings, some people might call ESP or even maybe some healing. And at first we were kind of afraid to know what it was for, and it was really deemed acceptable back then. And as we begin to explore that part of ourselves, we areas of what I consciousness that had not been available to us before. Because of that, our new generation, the Children of Now, are coming in with these abilities, and they're using them practically from the time they're born. What this is an extreme degree of sensitivity, an ability to, their thinking is compartmentalized, so extreme amounts of data. Where most of us in our generation are more linear thinkers. We call them ADD and ADHD, attention deficit disorder, or attention deficit hyperactive, when in fact, all they're doing is being who they are, because they don't just like, they absorb information energetically. Mm. And I know for a lot of people, it's a new concept, but it's very true. And remember past lives, some of them, they remember even being on the other side before they became children, and choosing their parents sometimes. And there's a million things I could tell you about them. But the biggest part of it is their sensitivity and what's happening and what we as a society to hurt them with all good intentions. And this is what I think you and I are going to be getting into today.
Well, that's fantastic. One of the things I want to ask you is looking at, just the children, not necessarily of now, but the children of today, and what they're going and growing through with technology and what have you. Do you think that there are some children that are losing their identities?
Oh, absolutely. Here's what's going on, Philippe. We have, first of all, a greater number of population in our world than ever before. It's hard to figure out how we fit in all. So there's real time all the time from our technologies, the media, YouTube, Facebook, there are so many places that we've got things coming at us from. It's really hard for us to feel ourselves anymore. All of this information is really messing up our sense of self. And with that and the technologies, what's occurring is that particularly with the kids, but not only with the kids, even with adults, and particularly, we're seeing a loss of personal connection. Kids are not getting that peace that we have where we make friends and they are solid and they're forever. And we can call each other 10 or 20 years later and pick up right where we left off.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the texting and because of the constant online interactions, there's no eye to eye. They're not seeing what when they say things to each other. And you can go in pretty much any restaurant now and you'll see them sitting at the table with their gadgets talking even to each other without speaking. That's depersonalized. And personalized, we lose the value of, and even further with the reality of video games, of special effects in the movies, by the way, both of which I love, we are losing the sense of a value of life. In other words, for example, in video games, you have a hero and everything looks extremely real. So you're shooting at people and you're being shot at. And if you get killed, it's okay. You get right back up and you have left. Well, that does something to the psychology in the subconscious. And what it's doing is it's devaluing life. It's taking away the sense of reality of, I shoot someone, it's no big deal because they're going to come back, or it won't matter because the
consequential
sense of reality. Yeah, exactly. So seeing so many events, and you know, the really scary thing when I was researching for my recent book in this series, The Children Now Evolution, which to the Book of Answers, I was absolutely the number of events that have happened with children killing their families, going into schools and killing their schoolmates, or just literally going out and shooting. And it was to see the numbers of that. And since then, as you know, it takes a little while for a book to hit the stand. Numbers have increased dramatically. And we're also seeing events with officers and other people, young adults, who are doing the same thing. And there's a lot of fear factor coming up. So we've got a new dynamic coming in. And it's really.
How would you say that? What's the role of parents in this new depersonalized world that these kids are being raised in and being exposed to, I should say? What is the role of the parent?
You know, that hasn't changed, but the dynamics have changed. Parents are there and how to live and be in our society, in our world, and how to be safe and how to interact with other people and a million other things. The problem is parents, many do so many hours that one of the most scary statistics that I found is that parents literally only spend 20 individual quality time with their child. So what we need to do is get back to that sense of family, a sense of intercommunication, and a sense of personalization. Stressed, things cost more, it's taking more just to survive, but yet we want to have families. That's part of our given desire, you know, and logical function. And so the rules have changed, the paradigms have changed with that.
Well, so when we look at the children of now with the depersonalization, with technology, what is your position on the children of now and this kind of, I mean, are they at risk because of the technology, in a sense, because they're being diagnosed that they have a behavioral disorder, and it's not really a behavioral disorder. It's just they're so advanced that they're being labeled, and can they end up turning out to not be a children of now, but a child of today?
Yeah, and you know, now on the child of today, terms really coexist. And what we're doing is, because of these children, they're internalizing. They don't know how to speak about their sensitivities because most of their peers of them start with. And that's what I've been trying to do for a number of years forward. We see that a lot, that children will internalize their feelings, their emotions, and then from there, I've seen a great number of them start to develop fantasies. They don't talk about it. They live them vicariously through the games or the, you know, the different technologies and that kind of thing. And it's that fantasy world that scares the heck out of me, because if we don't know what's going on inside of our children, we don't know what they're thinking, we don't know. And these are the children that are particularly societally in danger, because they're just like explode. All of that internalized stuff is going to have to come out at some point. At the same time, they fit. At the same time, they're depersonalized. And we've got a farm set up for exactly the kind of events we're seeing, being outlets to feel like somebody, to make their mark, to prove that they have power and value on a negative side. So that's why we're seeing so much of this. And getting back to earlier question, what we need to do is pull them back, get them to talk to us. You know, we're so busy, make that time. And the other piece of that is, what I recommend is safe space, is what I call it, in our homes. Parents and children will have a day or every week, whatever works, and sit down and be able to speak about that is going on and really check in deeply with each other. And in that safe zone, there would be no judgment, no punishment, no out on either end, just expressing, communicating. And a lot can happen. To feel, wow, my care, and they are listening. And mom and dad, I see where I need to really with my child to help them with these frustrations. And making that time is vital, because usually what happens is parents are walking in, and I don't mean everything, this is pretty general. And kids will ask question marks, and parents will give an answer and keep on going. And it's one of those, what I call typical general adult answers. And they didn't really hear what the child said. They didn't really read what was on the child's face or in their heart, because the parents have such big jobs on mm-hmm. them. And so we need to stop and look and pay attention. We're missing a lot of really important things. So many kids are committing suicide that if only we had taken that time, if only we had noticed, my child has changed. My child is not talking to me. My child is saying things that don't feel good. There's so many signals. And I also have lines to call for help and a lot of different things that we can look for and things that we can do to really help our kids get that sense of self-importance and self-confidence. And since it's vital that we get back to that.
When we talk about children committing suicide, gun violence is unfortunately one of the main topics of today. when we look at that,
yeah,
how can we save our children of now from becoming so frustrated, so unheard, so detached, that they become a child of today, and become a victim of gun violence, either by self-inflicted or by engaging in, you know, nefarious activities that will end up getting them killed?
Yeah, it's a great question, and it's the biggest one. And first of all, we need to make sure that guns are not accessible to our kids. A lot of the guns that are involved in these shootings come out of the home or a relative's home. And so there's nothing wrong with having them. People have them, but they need to be safely put away. And there's so much going on. You know, I'm frustrated, for instance, just looking for something to watch on TV at night. That are popular, that are mainstays, are all about murders and solving murders, and, you know, we've got to change the in society. We've got to give different messages that these things are not okay, because what we're doing is we're giving the message that, gee, this is commonplace. And so thirdly, we really need, once again, to get back to giving our children a sense of self-esteem and a connection to other people and its importance and how important we are really and truly in this world to make what we and kids are getting eyes all of this technology. And I've talked to a number of them writing the book and afterwards, because the kids are reading and they're saying, you know, everything that we do, everything in our lives, how we communicate, what we see, what we know, it's all where in that, you know, where are the controls on that keep our kids safe and keep good messages coming rather than some of the things that are coming to them. We need to be able to make the effort to give that supervision to our kids so they are safe. And what by safe I mean what's going inside of them and not that bruise in a time where it comes out in a horrid way. And we don't need And it's happening time after time, literally, at this point. There was a story a couple of days ago online where a girl in New York City killed her parents, went out partying all night, and they were laying there dead for a couple of days before somebody hadn't heard from them and checked on them. And she was out partying and didn't think much of it.
Wow.
I mean, that is unreal. And we need to get back to what is real, what does matter, and stay with that, you know. And I think that the media needs to take a lot of responsibility in that. You and I are part of that. Mm-hmm. And I love the fact that we're able to get out and talk very frankly about this. There's so much needed. Another piece of this is the school systems. They're archaic. They're working on a curriculum that's over 100 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Those curriculums are based on values that background, but don't fit. So the school system to update the curriculums and also the environments. These kids are highly sensitive. They're environmentally sensitive. Their sense and visual fields, you know, clutter and those kinds of things upset them energetically. And so we've really got to be able to 24 create new environments and new ways of dealing with it. But it takes all of us, not just a few of us talking about it.
Absolutely. How can people get in contact with you, learn about the children of now evolution, and this new should I say species, or should I say evolving human being? How can people get in contact with you and find out more about that?
Thank you. First of all, what I want to believe is what we're looking at is a fast forward evolution of humanity. We are evolving faster than we can keep up. Our technology has outgrown our psychology. We need to work. Thanks. We need to work really hard on finding a balance with that. If you want to get in touch with me, you can email at docspirits, that's docspirit, at touchingthelight.org. That's my main general email. And I also have a couple of websites. My main is spiritlight at spiritlite.com. A lot on there, a lot of good links, a lot of good references, and it's free. I mean, you can peruse my website all day long if you want. There's a lot there, and of course, my books are everywhere. If you go to the author page for me on Amazon, you can find everything in the series and all the other things that I write about, which actually explain what we can do and how.
Fantastic. Dr. Meg, thank you for being with me today and sharing this wonderful information on gun violence, the children of now, the children of today, and giving some solutions as to what we can do and what we should be looking out for. As you know, you're part of the network. I want you to come back. We're going to also have you on our radio show momentarily and continue this conversation about saving our children and saving families, and literally being evolved and what that means to be evolved. So I just want to thank you personally for being with me today.
Thank you so much for having me. It's an honor and a pleasure. And thanks to everyone out there who's listening. Without you, we don't have much to do.
That's true. Stick around, hang out in the green room as I sign off. Don't go anywhere. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being with me today. Dr. Meg Blackburn Losey, author of The Children of Now Evolution, touchthelight.org, touchthelight.org. Go there and download this incredible book, piece of work that will help you raise enlightened and evolved children. We'll see you next time on the Philippe Matthews Show live and our network.